Hallelujah. Yahweh Barak and Shalom to Kol Yisrael. Those of you that are with us here, Teshua, you that are listening by via live stream or our radio station, there are those that do listen within the area here in Jefferson, Pageland area. So we say our Shalom unto you. May Yahweh Barak you all on this Wednesday night, this convey immense scripture truth. And what I want to do, Yisrael, on this day, it just somewhat remind us that we zakah, that we remember, that we obey, that we do according to what Yahweh instructs us to do, as we heard Isaac came ben me as he read concerning his commandments. Because in order for us to grow and to be happy and content with the things that Almighty Yahweh is doing in this hour, we must walk in and we must obey his commandments. Many times we as a people, as a nation, we have our own way, our own idea, our own path. We have our own instruments. But what we find which come out of that, the fruits of that, is just death. It's not those things that bring life. It's not those things that bring the excitement or, as I mentioned, the happiness to us as a people. We must walk in his commandments. We must obey his commandments. And if we go any other way besides that, his mitzvah, then we are wrong, Israel.
Yes, yes.
We're walking contrary to his word. So we must, Yisrael, obey. So let me start this in Deuteronomy, chapter 11, verse 26, Deuteronomy. Because Yahweh has set a path for us this day, has he not? When we awaken, the path of Siddiq of righteousness has already been laid, the footsteps, this path, in Yahshua HaMashiach. So if we go any other way, if we go out of what he has established, out of the path, then we'll find ourselves lost. Because without his instructions, without his commandments, how do we know his way, the only way, which we should live, which we should go, Yisrael? So it says here in Deuteronomy, chapter 11, verse 26, he says, behold, I set, I lay down, I have established before us. Does not Yahshua go before us? Is he not the tough shepherd, Yisrael? He said he goes before us. Why? Why must a shepherd go before the sheep? To lead, to guide, to instruct. Is that not what the Torah does? Is it not what Yahshua HaMashiach does? He commands, he instructs us to walk in the commandments. He said, I set before you this day a blessing and also a curse. His Berakiah. He set it before us, Yisrael. His commandments that we should walk therein. That we should obey. Why? That we may grow. That we will be happy as a nation, as a people. That we will asa, do his commandments. It goes on in verse 27 and says, a blessing if you obey. What is obey? Do we think it's as the action of you just simply going and doing that thing? It is beyond that. It is just simply Shema, to listen, to hear, to observe, to pay attention. He said, we must obey. If you will obey Shema, what? The commandments, the instructions, his law, his order. He said, obey the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, your Abba. He said, which I command you this day. Verse 28. He said, and a curse, if you will not obey the commandments of Yahweh, if you will not hearken, if you will not hear, we must hearken, we must hear, we must shema up first, Israel. Yeah, then we are sa, we do, we accomplish it. We set out for to do the thing which he has commanded us to do. He said, obey the commandments of Yahweh, your Almighty, but turn aside out of the way which I command you. He said, this is what will happen if you turn aside out of my commandments, out of this way, out of the path which I have laid before you this day. And if you will go after and follow gods, don't we do that, Israel? Yeah. We've done that, have we not? The God of our own imagination, the God of our own ideas, the God of our bellies, the God of our mind, our lust. He said, if you will go after other gods, he said, which you do not even know. You do not even know them. There's no experience. There should be an experience we all have with Almighty Yahweh. Knowing that he provides everything that we need, Israel. Yet, walking in his mitzvot, his commandments, Israel, we find it hard. Why is that? Does not the Torah speak about our iniquity, our transgression, as being a stumbling block? It's hard to walk a straight path and stumbling and tripling and falling all the time, Israel. It slows you down from getting, it slows you down from getting to your destination. You're bruised, you're hurt. But yet, if we will walk in the commandments of Almighty Yahweh and set aside all those other things, Israel, then the way will be quick. It will be easy for us. Deuteronomy chapter 13, we will move there. Concerning his commandments, Israel, we should not allow anyone. And immediately we think about others, but not even our own self. The hidden man of our own left. Yeah. Convince us to walk contrary to the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. We convince ourselves time after time. We work and we try to find ways to get out of the chore. Yeah. Or maybe accomplish that chore quickly. But sometimes there's no other way, no other way but just to do it. Go in full throttle. Go in head first. Hallelujah. He says in verse 1, Debrim, chapter 13. He says, if there arise among you a Nabi, a prophet, those false things, Israel, that are in our own lives, in our own thoughts. Or a dreamer of dreams, and he gives you, what, a sign. Yes. Or a wonder. And the sign or the wonder come to pass. Yes. You would think there would be much belief when someone has a sign and it comes to pass. And you somewhat want to believe that it is real. That is a tough thing because it came to pass. But look what Torah says. And that sign or that wonder, it come to pass. Wherefore he spoke unto you, saying, let us go after and follow other gods. Those things that are not of Almighty Yahweh. He said, which you have not known, and let us serve them. He says in verse 3, you shall not hearken. He said, you shall not hearken. We hearken to so many things. There's so many things that cause us to stop. It causes us to lose focus. We turn to the left to observe this and to observe that. When Yahweh has already set, did he not say he set before us the way, his commandments? But there are things that obscure the view, which calls us to look in another direction, Israel, or try to find another path. He said, hearken not to the words of that Nabi, of that prophet, or that dreamer of dreams. For Yahweh, your Almighty, he proves you. He instructs you. Why? Why are his commandments so important? He said he proves you to know whether you ahava him. With what? All. Kol. The entirety of your land, your being, Yisrael. So he tries us. But yet he has given us his commandments. He has given us, as I have read this day, life and death. His commandments, Yisrael. What have we chosen? What do we choose, Yisrael? He said, to love Almighty Yahweh with all of your love and with all of your nephesh, with all of your being. That's what he commands of us. That's what he desires of us, Yisrael. Verse 4. He said, you shall walk after Yahweh, your sovereign master, and we must fear him. We must Yirai, we must Yareh, we must fear him. And keep his commandments. We must keep his commandments. We must hide them in our left, Yisrael, that we not go astray, that we not sin before Almighty Yahweh. Keep his commandments and obey. Shema. Obey his voice. And you shall serve Almighty Yahweh, and you shall grasp hold, you shall cleave unto him. When you cleave unto something, it's more than just holding. But it's grasping that thing like it's the only thing that will save your very life. We must grasp onto Yahshua HaMashiach because he is our Yahshak. We must let go of those things that hold us and pin us down. The weight of the world, the weight of our own mind, those things that are outside of the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. We must get rid of them, Yisrael. We must lay them down and walk after the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, his mitzvah. Don't you want the blessings of Almighty Yahweh? Nothing can compare. Torah says, even the mi'ot or the small things that a tzaddik man has, they're more than even the riches of the world. More than all the gold. More than all the dollar bills. Any skyscraper, a home, or land does not compare to even that which a righteous man, a tzaddik man has. So we must obey his mitzvah, that is his order, his charge, his precepts. It's those things that by reason of his office that he has established, Yisrael, instruction. Aren't there laws? Everywhere you go, there's a law. Whether you're on the highway, whether you enter into a convenience store, sometimes if you would pay attention, you would see a sign that says you must wear a shirt or you have to have shoes. There's certain codes that you must obey. So is it with Almighty Yahweh. I want to move to the rear of the mitzvah, the Torah, to Revelation, chapter 22, verse 14. You hear those, they talk about the blessings of, quote, God, unquote, or they're, quote, Jesus, unquote. Well, there are no blessings in God or in Jesus Christ. The only blessings that are found are in Almighty Yahweh, in Yahshua HaMashiach. So, if Yahweh baraks, or he blesses in the beginning of all things, even at the end of that thing, does he not have a blessing in store for Yisrael if we endure? So look what it says here in Revelation, Gilayana, chapter 22, verse 14. He said, Barak, blessed are they. Is that anyone? Does that ascribe to anyone or just Yisrael? Does not the Torah, when one obeys the Torah, whether he is a Gentile of the Zerah, the seed, if he walk according to the statutes, the mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh, He said, blessed are they that asa, that fashion, that do, that accomplish or observe his mitzvot, his commandments. That they may have right. I want to have right. Don't you want to have right, Israel? In the United States, they tell you that you have rights, but really you don't have rights. But we have rights in Yahshua HaMashiach. We have rights in the mitzvah, in the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. And those rights can no one take away. I recall the old song that I would hear sing amongst the congregation. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. The Yahweh that Almighty Yahweh has, that he gives unto us. The world cannot give it, the world cannot take it away. The world cannot take away the mitzvah, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. It says that his mitzvah, that they may have right to the tree of life. We have right to the tree of life. As long as we continue to walk in his commandments, Yisrael, as we obey the mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh, and may enter through the gates into the city. Hallelujah. Is not Yahshua HaMashiach the door? We cannot come but through Yahshua HaMashiach. There's no other way we can enter to the gates of New Jerusalem or Jerusalem unless we obey the commandments of Almighty Yahweh.
Yes, sir.
Do not we hear about the deep things of Almighty Yahweh? We cannot enter those things or understand those things without walking in his commandments, Yisrael, obeying his mitzvot. It also says here, as we move on tonight, Yisrael, turn with me to Debrim again, Deuteronomy chapter 27, verse 10. Concerning the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, he commands us to walk according to his statutes, according to the Torah, according to the law of Israel. And if we would do that, he will barak, he will bless us. It says in Deuteronomy, Debrim chapter 27, verse 10, he says, you shall therefore obey the voice of Almighty Yahweh, your Abba, and do his mitzvah, his commandments, and his statutes, the hook. What are the statutes? They're the regulations. It's what established those points for us of the barrier that we're not going outside of or beyond those things Yahweh commands us. Ahava your Akim. Do Sadiq, do right unto all men, but especially those of the house of the congregation of Almighty Yahweh. He said, the ordinances which I command you this day. Is he talking about this day? Or was he talking about yesterday? Or when this ketuvah was written? He's talking about today. His mitzvah is a living mitzvah. He's talking about today, right now, Yisrael. We must obey his commandments this day. We must walk according to his statutes, according to his ordinance, Yisrael. Turn with me to Tehillim, chapter 11, 111, verse 9. How do we get this knowledge, or the knowledge of his mitzvah, his commandments, Yisrael? How do we understand? How do we know that we're walking in his mitzvah and his commandments? It simply says here in Tehillim, 111, verse 9. The Torah says he sent redemption to call Yisrael, his people. He has commanded his Brit Olam, Kodesh, and awesome, and reverend, Yahweh, fear, is his name. His name, it demands respect and honor, Yisrael.
Absolutely.
It demands us to walk according to his commandments and his mitzvot. Verse 10. It says that the fear of Yahweh, the Yahweh, is the beginning of wisdom. Do we not hear that often? We hear that often here, Yisrael.
Yeah.
We must, Zakai, we must remember.
The
fear of Almighty Yahweh is the beginning of his wisdom. And the Torah says, tough understanding. Have all they. How do we come to this understanding? He says, tough understanding. Have all they that do the asah, his commandments, his mitzvot. That's how we have understanding, by simply obeying, by simply walking in it, by simply doing it, walking in the instructions of Almighty Yahweh. And by doing that, Yisrael, it says that his praises, they endure forever. His praises endure forever. We must walk in his mitzvah. We must walk in his commandments, Yisrael. Praises is more than one just raising their voices, but it is also walking in the mitzvah. It's saying, one saying that I agree, you are right, Almighty Yahweh. I comply, I submit, that I walk in your mitzvah, that I obey your commandments. And within that, we show the praises towards Almighty Yahweh, above all things. Above all things, Israel. I want to move to Sharak. Sharak chapter 19, verse 19. His mitzvahs, they are key, they are important, Yisrael, in this walk. We cannot walk. We cannot follow this path as Yahshua HaMashiach leads before us if we do not walk in his commandments, his mitzvah. Sharak says in chapter 19, verse 19, concerning the knowledge of his mitzvah, I want life, Yisrael. Is there anyone here that do not desire to live or have life?
Yes,
that one life is prolonged?
Yeah.
That Yahweh will add days of happiness and contentment, Yisrael?
I will buy it.
He says here, the knowledge of his mitzvah, the knowledge of his commandments of Almighty Yahweh, is the doctrine now. It is the doctrine. It is laid. It is established. It's the foundation of life. That's what his mitzvah is. It's the foundation of life. You cannot have life without the mitzvah, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Because as he speaks, Yisrael, there's life. And even in death, there is life. Why? Because his mitzvah is being accomplished. And it is established, Yisrael. So his mitzvah and the knowledge of that is the doctrine of life. And they that do those things that please him. Do we want to please him, Yisrael?
Yeah.
Lift your hands if you want to please him tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is what the commandments instructs us. And they that do those things that please him, they shall receive the fruit. Why? Because we have right. How? By his mitzvah, by his commandments. Because we obey and we walk in them. We are hava, we love them. So we have the right. And he shall receive the fruits of the tree of eternal life, of immortality. Going beyond this flesh, this mindset, this body that perishes every second of every day, every hour of every day, it wastes away. But yet we have right to the tree that we may partake of those fruits of life, Yisrael. Immortality, life everlasting, the light of life in Yahshua HaMashiach. We have right to that. Verse 20, For the fear of Yahweh is some wisdom. Even you that don't have that, you know that's not true. Shirach says that the fear of Yahweh is cold. It is all. It is all. It is everything. It is all wisdom. And in all wisdom is the performance of the Torah. That's how we shall perform. That's how we are sung. That's how we walk according to the commandments of the mitzvah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. For the performance of the Torah and the knowledge, the understanding of his power. There's no other way we're going to understand this power. There's no other way we're going to understand the workings and the acts of Almighty Yahweh unless we walk in his mitzvot, his commandments, Yisrael. There's no other way. We cannot get around it. We cannot escape this. We must obey all of his commandments. We must obey his commandments that we may have knowledge of his power, of those deep things. As we have heard, Israel, that there's understanding. That we don't come before the presence of Almighty Yahweh dumb, not understanding what his pleasure, what his tough pleasure is, Israel, his hafit, what he desires, what he wants, what he desires in a people and a nation. Those things he wants us to have, Israel. He wants us to have those things. But we must walk according to his mitzvot, his commandments. Turn me back to Tehillim. Hallelujah. Tehillim 111. Tehillim 112. I'm sorry. Tehillim 112, verse 1. Hallelujah. Again, Yisrael, I just desire to remind us today of the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. That we cannot walk outside of them. We must walk in them. We must obey them, Yisrael. Then we will receive the blessings, the berakiah of Almighty Yahweh. But it only comes one way, and that is by obeying the mitzvot, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Tehillim 112, verse 1 says, Hallelujah, Yahweh. Blessed is the man that Yahweh, that fears Almighty Yahweh. How do we know that one fears Almighty Yahweh? Look what it says next. That delights, but not only that delights, but Torah says greatly. He greatly delights. He greatly delights. In his mitzvot, his commandments. That even in verse 2, that is his zerah, his seed, his children, shall be mighty upon the olam. I want our children, our bane, to be mighty upon the olam. When we as parents, as zakein, when we move on, we want our children to be mighty. To stand in the mitzvah. Yeah. That's the only way we're going to be mighty. That's the only way they will be mighty. It's by walking in the mitzvah, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. He said we walk in his commandments, that even our children, our babe, our zerah, will be mighty. And they will be blessed, Yisrael. It says that the generation of the upright shall be blessed. Yeah. Shall receive the barakah. The blessings that come right from Almighty Yahweh. Doesn't he rain down his blessings, his berakiah upon us, Yisrael? Well, we have life tonight, do we not? Didn't we just take that breath? Then after that breath, another breath. It's a blessing just to be alive, that we are able to breathe. That we're able to sing. That we're able to shout. that we're able to give todah unto Almighty Yahweh. No matter what situation or circumstance that you are in, you can give todah unto Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tehillim 112 verse 3. He says, wealth and riches. Is that not what the world they go after? Wealth and riches. Men, they die for wealth and for riches. They would kill another man for wealth and for riches. But look what Torah says here in Tehillim 112 and verse 3. It says that wealth and riches shall be in his bed.
Yes.
Shall be in your house. Shall be in my house. Shall be in the house of Almighty Yahweh. And we continue to walk according to his mitzvah. And it says, and his tzaddik, his righteousness, it endures forever. Hallelujah. His righteousness endures forever. His ahava endures forever. Hallelujah. It endures forever. It cannot, does not run out. It does not grow weary, Israel.
That's right.
But we must walk in the mitzvah, the commandments. His commandments are key to everything, Israel. His commandments, his mitzvah. Tehillim 119, verse 35, as we move along tonight, Israel. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tehillim 119, chapter 119, verse 35. How do we get delight, or we delight in this life, Israel? Well, now we find out here in Tehillim, David speaks many things, but the only way we are going to receive life is this way, 119 verse 35. He cries out unto Almighty Yahweh to make me to go in the pathway of your commandments, your mitzvah, for therein do I delight. That's the only way. Yahweh opens up the path in his mitzvah that leads unto life, Israel. We must walk in them with delight.
Yes.
With delight.
Yes. Beautiful.
With excitement, with joy, and with confidence, Israel. That no matter what we experience or what we go through,
yes,
there is great contentment.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Knowing that we are walking in the mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh. Man cannot touch us. Shatan, he cannot do one thing unto us, Israel, as long as we're walking according to his mitzvah and his commandments.
Yeah.
Moving along. Second Kings chapter 20, verse 21. This is the prayer of Manasseh, 20, verse 21. And Hezekiah, he slept with his fathers. And Manasseh, which is the king of Yehuda, his sons reigned in his stead. Now this reign of Manasseh was one of wickedness. Did not walk after the commandments or the statutes of Almighty Yahweh, his mitzvah. Verse, chapter 21, verse 1. It said that Manasseh was 12 years old when he began to reign. And he reigned 55 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Hephzibah. And he did that which was evil, which was detestable. Those things that dishonored Almighty Yahweh. He did those things which were evil in the sight of Almighty Yahweh. After the abominations of the heathen, whom Yahweh has cast out before the children of Israel. Yahweh has cast those things out. He has removed those things. But because this king did not walk after the statutes and the mitzvot of Almighty Yahweh, there are all sorts of evil things entered in to Jerusalem. Because he did not walk according to the statutes and the mitzvot of Almighty Yahweh. Verse 3, 2 Kings 21, verse 3. For he built up again. How many of us have done that? We rebuke, we reprove, we reprove. Those walls are torn down that keeps us from walking according to the mitzvah, the statutes, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. And we find ourselves regressing, and we start building those walls again. We start building those things that displease Almighty Yahweh. We raise up those things that dishonor Almighty Yahweh. So he built up again the high places which Hezekiah, his father, had destroyed. And he reared up altars for Belial and made a grove, as did Abba, king of Israel, Ahab, king of Israel. And he worshiped all the hosts of the Hashemayim, and he served them, and he built altars unto those gods in the house of Almighty Yahweh, of which Yahweh commanded, he said, in Yerushalayim, I will put my name. Yahweh, he placed his name in the bed of Yerushalayim. And we found ourselves building altars and groves unto the lust of our flesh and to the will of what we want, Yisrael. That's what we do. Yahweh, he tears down, we find ourselves by the flesh rebuilding those things again, Yisrael. Yeah. And it should not be so. Well, Zakane, how do we make sure that we continue to walk and that we not fall back? It's just simple as this. We continue to walk in his commandments, his mitzvot. And we will never go back to those weak and beggarly elements of the world, Yisrael. Hallelujah. This is the prayer of Manasseh, king of Yehuda. His sins were great because he forgot the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. So I want to read this. This is his prayer. It says here, just listen, Yisrael. Yeah. O sovereign Yahweh, almighty of our fathers, Abram, Yitzhak, and Yaakov, and of their righteous Zerah, their seed, who has made the Shemayim and the Olam with all the ornaments thereof, who has bound the seas by the word of his commandments. Yes. That's how the seas are bound. Yes. By simply the words of his commandment, Yisrael. They will not go beyond their boundaries unless he said, see, I want you to go this far. Yes. And I want you to stop right there and go back. It says, they are set by his commandments, who has shut up the deep and is sealed by the power of your terrible and mighty name. He said, whom all men fear and tremble before you. He said, your majesty of your beauty, of man, it cannot be bare. And your angry threatenings towards the sinners is unportable. But your loving promises is immeasurable, and they are unsearchable. Yes. Have we not heard about those things that are unsearchable? Yes. That even his ahava towards us, Israel, is unsearchable. Yes. We're not going to be able to figure that out by means of the flesh or this mind, because it's unsearchable. For you are the Most High Abba, Yahweh, of great compassion, long-suffering, full of kindness. Now remember, this is the prayer of Manasseh, king of Yehuda. And repent of the evils of men. He says, you, O Yahweh, according to your great Ahava, your tongue, have promised repentance and forgiveness to them that have sinned against you. He promised forgiveness. He promised his Yashat before us, Israel. He said, and of your infinite kindness has appointed repentance to sinners. I barak Yahweh for that. Yes. For without that appointment, Yisrael, there's no way that we will be acceptable before the presence of Almighty Yahweh. Yes. Why? That they may be Yasha. Yes. That they may be saved. That we may be saved, Yisrael. Yes. Manasseh goes and says, you are therefore, O Yahweh, You are the Almighty One of the just. And you have not appointed repentance to the just, as to Abram, as to Yitzhak and Yaakov, which have not sinned against you. But he says, but you have appointed repentance unto me. Yahweh has appointed repentance unto us, Israel. Why? Because he was able, Manasseh, he was able to confess that he is a sinner. He said, I am a sinner. He said, I have walked away from your mitzvah and your Torah. I have walked away from your commandments and your statutes. He goes on, he's praying now. Supplications unto Almighty Yahweh. He said, for I have sinned above the number of the sands of the sea. What a confession. What great honesty. We don't believe we sin more than the sands of the sea. We don't believe that our sins are great before Almighty Yahweh. That there are countless things we have done whereby there's even no remembrance of those things. But yet Yahweh, his Ahava, is great towards Yisrael. He goes on and says, my transgressions, Almighty Yahweh, they are multiplied. He said, my transgressions are multiplied. And I am not worthy to be and to see the heights of Hashemayim. He said, I'm not even worthy to lift up my head and my hands before you, Almighty Yahweh. For the multitude of my iniquities. He said, I am bowed down with many iron bands that I cannot lift up my head. Neither have I any release. He said, I don't have any relief. He goes on and prays, for I have provoked your wrath, Almighty Yahweh, and have done evil before you. He said, I did not your will. He said, I didn't do your will. He said, I didn't do your commandments. I didn't do those things you have instructed me to do, Almighty Yah. He said, neither have I kept your commandments. He knew that he did not keep the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Why? Because the commandments of Yahweh, they bring life. They bring health. They bring wealth. They bring contentment before Almighty Yahweh. He said, I have not kept your commandments. He said, I have set up abominations, and I have multiplied offenses before you. He prays now, therefore. He said, I bow the knee of my left. He did more than just bow his physical knee. He bowed the knee of his left. He bent down before Almighty Yahweh, prostrate. He said, I beseech you, your Ahava, Almighty Yahweh. He said, I have sinned. Oh, Yahweh, I have sinned. And he said, I lack knowledge. We lack knowledge, Israel. He said, I lack knowledge of mine iniquities. Wherefore, I humbly beseech you, Almighty Yahweh, he says, to forgive me. Forgive me, O Yahweh, forgive me. And destroy me not with mine iniquities. We don't want to be destroyed with our iniquities, Israel. Because it's those things that condemn us into the pit, into Sheol, into hell. He said, do not destroy me with my iniquities. Yes. He said, be not angry with me forever by reserving evil before me, neither condemn me to the lower parts of the earth. For you are Almighty Yahweh, even the Almighty One of them that repent. He continues to pray and says, and in me, you will show all of your tongue. He believed that. Even all the iniquity, those things he had committed before Almighty Yahweh, not walking according to his mitzvah, his commandments, yet he believed that Almighty Yahweh, his Ahava, that he would forgive him. Because his tongue is so great. He said, for you will save me, which I am unworthy. He says, according to your great kindness, therefore, he says, I will praise you forever, all the days of my life. For all the powers of the Shemayim do praise you, and yours is the honor forever and ever. So be it.
Yes, so be it, all
Hallelujah. When the last time we have prayed and bowed the knee of our love before Almighty Yahweh and confessed all before Him, Israel, that we have not walked according to His commandments, according to His statutes, Israel. Yet His Ahava is so great, Israel. Even He realized if He would confess His sins before Almighty Yahweh, that there would be and that there is forgiveness for His sins. Hallelujah. I barak Yahweh for that. That even tonight, Israel, there's forgiveness for our sins. But we must walk according to His mitzvah. We must walk according to His commandments.
Yes,
not to walk in them and then knowingly with understanding. He said, I did not understand. Having the understanding and the knowledge of those things, we regress and turn back.
Yes.
We must continue, Israel. We must continue in this straight and narrow path to the Melkut, the kingdom of Almighty Yahweh. Turn with me to Matitiah, Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Do we think we can continue to break the mitzvah of the commandments of Almighty Yahweh and that there will be no judgment for it? You see what it says here in Matitiah, Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. He says here, he said, think not that I am come to destroy the Torah.
No,
they don't think I came to destroy the Torah. That those that believe that He come to destroy the Torah, we don't have to walk under the commandments anymore. That is a lie. It is false. Yahshua said, I did not come to destroy the commandments of the Torah or of the Nabi, the prophets. He said, I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. Do we think we have any less of a responsibility, Israel? We must fulfill the commandments of Almighty Yahweh.
Yes.
He said to verse 18, for truly I say to you, till the Hashemiah and the earth pass, he said, not one jot nor one tittle shall in no wise pass from the Torah of Almighty Yahweh until it all be fulfilled. To it all is accomplished. To it all is finished, Israel. Verse 19. He says, for whosoever therefore shall break one. Does it say one? Does it say one in your Torah, Yosef? It says one, does it not? So we cannot get by with just one, Israel. He said, for whosoever shall break one of the least of these commandments, and shall teach men so, and shall instruct men too, that we don't have to obey or observe the Shabbat, Zakah, and that we set it apart, Israel. He says, one mitzvah, one commandment, and teach so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of Hashemiah. And whosoever shall do and teach them, he says, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of Hashemiah. So should we teach that we should do them? That we should walk according to His mitzvah, His statutes? That we should observe and obey the feasts of Almighty Yahweh? We should do those things, Israel. Yahweh commands that. That is a commandment of us to do those things. Moving quickly, Matitiah chapter 15, verse 7. You know, men, they have their commandments. They have their law books. They have documents that they go to. But Yahweh says He despises the commandments of man. Why? Because the commandments of man leads to nothing but death. But Yah's mitzvah leads to life, Israel. It says in Matthew chapter 15, verse 7. He says, for you hypocrites, where did Isaiah prophesy of you, saying, this people draw nigh to me with their mouth. Do we think Yahweh just want our mouth?
Yes.
Or as they would say, lip service? He wants more than that, Israel. He said, this people draw nigh unto me with their mouth and honors me with their lips, But their lev, their levine, their heart, they are far from me. Verse 9, he says, but vain do they worship me. Why? Why is it vain? Are they not giving Almighty Yahweh lip service, praising with their lips? But yet they do not walk after the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. It's no tough. You can't do that, Israel. It does not work. It's not acceptable for Almighty Yahweh. He said, but vain do they worship. Why? Because they follow their doctrines and what they believe and what they want and what they have established. But in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrine the commandments of men. That's what they teach, Israel. We have all done those things. Even these pagan holidays, the Christmases and all that stuff, we have been taught those things. We have taught those things. But it's time, Israel, for us to walk according to the mishpah, to Yahweh's commandments, not the commandments of man, not those things that man have established, but what Yahweh has again set before us, hallelujah, his commandments. Let me read this quickly as we move on. We're still in Matitiah, chapter 19, verse 16. Hallelujah. Is there more than one way to get into the kingdom? The Melchut Yisrael? There's only one way, is it not? Through Yahshua HaMashiach. The commandments, obeying the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. It says here in Matthew, Matitiah, chapter 19, verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, tough, master. You're just so wonderful. You're tough. You're excellent. What tough things shall I do that I may have eternal life? Did not we talk about eternal life? Did not I talk about it? Having the right to the tree. But we must what? Obey the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. That's what we're missing, Israel, is obeying the commandments. What is this young man missing? It says in verse 17, Yahshua said unto him, why call me tough? There's only one, that is Almighty Yahweh. But if you will enter into life, he says, keep the commandments. He told him to keep the commandments. If we recall this situation, did not the young man say, well, I have obeyed those things from my youth? But yet Yahshua said, but you lack one. He said, go and sell what you have. He said, give it away. Get rid of it. Take up the stake and follow me. Was that not also a commandment? But what did he do? He went away sorrowful. We must obey the commandments. That's the only way we're going to be happy. That we not turn and go away sorrowful, Yisrael. We must obey the commandments. We must keep the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Moving on quickly as I bring this to a close tonight. I want to read from Yasher, chapter 26. I want to read 21. A few more scriptures here, Yisrael. To 28. Because it's the only way that Abram received the blessings of Almighty Yahweh. And there's only one way we shall be overtaken and flooded by these blessings, these berakah for Almighty Yahweh. And that is by walking in his instructions, his commandments. Yahshua says here in verse 20, chapter 26, verse 21, concerning Abram. And Abram, he gave all that he had to his son, Yitzhak. And he also gave him all of his treasures. And he commanded him. Did he not give him commandment? Did he not instruct him? He told him. He commanded him, saying, did you not understand, Yada? Did you not know and understand?
Yes.
Yahweh, that he is the Almighty One of Hashemayim, of the Olam.
Yes.
He said, do you not understand? Do you not Yada that? Mm-hmm. Do you not take that into recognition. That you apply that, you believe that, my son. And he says, is there any besides him? There's none beside Almighty Yahweh. None besides Almighty Yahweh. And it was he that took me from my father's house and from my birthplace. And he gave me all the delights upon the earth. Who delivered me from the counsel of the wicked. He said, for in Yahweh do I trust. And he brought me into this place. And he delivered me from Ur. And Kadesh, and cast him. And he said unto me, for your Zerah, your seed, your children, will I give all these land. And they shall inherit them when they keep. When they keep my commandments. We must keep his commandments. That is the only way we're going to be happy in Yahshua HaMashiach. He said, keep my commandments, my statutes, and my judgments that I have commanded you and which I shall command unto you. He said in verse 25, now therefore, my son, hearken unto my voice. He said, obey, Shema, and keep the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, your sovereign master, which I command you to do this day. And he says unto his son, as he instructs and he commands him, do not turn from the right way. He said, don't turn from the right way. Don't turn from the path of his commandments, which he has set before you. He said, don't go to the right, nor turn to the left, in order that it may be well with you and your children after you forever. We must obey the commandments. We must obey the mitzvoth of Almighty Yahweh. That's the only way our children will continue in this way, that they will be mighty Israel, strong, and overcome all things by Yahweh's commandment. And he instructs and remember the wonderful works of Almighty Yahweh. Had not Yahweh done mighty and wonderful works for us, Israel? We should not forget those things. Even sometimes the small things we take for granted. It is a mighty work of Almighty Yahweh. Because it has brought us to where we are today, Israel. It said, do not forget his wonderful works and his kindness that he has shown towards us. And having delivered us from the hands of our enemies. And he delivers us continually, Israel, from the hands of our enemies. Why? Because his commandments, they do stand. And they stand forever. He said, therefore, keep all that I have commanded you and turn not away from the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, your master. And serve none besides him. He said, serve Yahweh. He said, my son, I'm instructing you to serve Yahweh and serve Yahweh alone. Why? He says, in order that it may be well with you and your Zerah, your seed, your bane, your children forever after you. He instructs him to teach your children and your seed the instructions of Almighty Yahweh. He said, teach the instructions. He said, keep his commandments and teach them the upright way which they should go in order that they may dwell or be well with them forever. And Yashab, he answered and said unto Almighty, he answered and said unto his father, that which my master has commanded me, that will I do. Do we do what the Torah commands us, Yisrael? Yahshua, he commands us every day to walk according to the Mishra and the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. He confesses and says before his father, and I will not depart from the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, my sovereign ruler. He said, I will keep all that he has commanded me. And Abram blessed Yitzhak, his son. How are we going to be blessed, Israel, in this hour, in this time? We must obey his commandments. We must obey his commandments. So he blessed his son, Yitzhak, and also his children. And Abram, he taught Yaakov the instructions of Almighty Yahweh and his ways. So we must walk after his commandments, his instructions, those things he has set before us. Does not he set tough things before us, Israel? For us to walk and to grow. So we must continue in those things. Hallelujah. I want to read here in 1 Malachim, as I bring this to a close tonight, Israel, that we will be reminded to Zakah to remember the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, that we walk in them, that we obey them. This is the only way we shall prosper, Israel. Right here it says in 1 Malachim, 1 Kings chapter 2, verse 1 through 3, I want to read. It says, now the days of Dawid drew nigh that he should die. His time was coming to an end. That appointed time was very close. And he charged Solomon, his son, saying, I go the way of the earth. He said, I go back to the ground. I go back to the elements that Almighty Yahweh had brought me forth. Back to the dirt. He instructs him to be strong, therefore, and show yourself as a man. He says, show yourself as a warrior. Walk strong. Walk upright. Verse 3. Yes. And he says, and keep the charge, the commandments, the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, your Abba. And what is those commandments? He says right here, to walk in his ways and keep his statutes and his commandments. Hallelujah. It says also his judgments, the testimonies, and it is written of the Torah of Moshe, why that you may prosper, that you may prosper, that we may prosper, Yisrael, in all that you do, and whatever way that you turn yourself. That's the only way we shall prosper, Yisrael, that is walking in the mishpah, in the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. My last verse before I bring this to a close tonight. It's in 1st Debrahim, 1st Chronicles chapter 29, verse 18. There's a certain kind of love, a desire that we must have, Israel, that we keep the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. And this is Dawid's, this is his prayer. This is his prayer unto Almighty Yah. He says, O Yahweh, my sovereign master of Abram, Yitzhak, and Yaakov, of Yisrael, our fathers. He said, keep this in the mind and the imagination of the thoughts of the love of your people. Yes. It must be kept, his commandments, those things he has instructed us, this love that we must have, Yisrael, that we obey Almighty Yahweh. He says, and prepare. The lev must be prepared. The lev must be ready. The lev must be open before Almighty Yahweh. That's what kind of lev we must have, Israel. Yeah. That was his prayer. That his lev would be open to the instructions and the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. He said, and prepare the lev unto you. Yeah. That's the kind of lev we must have, Israel. One that is prepared. That is ready. What? To walk in the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Despite what man says, man's commandments, our own thoughts, what we want to do, we must have our love. It must be open before Almighty Yahweh, that we shema, that we obey, that we hear, and that we walk according to the instructions and the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. Yes. Todiyah. Todiyah for all things, Israel. For it is by him and only him, by his commandments, that we are alive today. His ahava is great. His kindness, his love kindness, as we heard tonight, it is great, Israel. And also his commandments, they are very great. Hallelujah. So nothing else tonight, Israel, I implore you. I want to encourage you to continue to walk in the commandments, the instructions of Almighty Yahweh. And if we will do so, obey those things, then we will find no room to complain, to be disgruntled before Almighty Yahweh. But we continue to give him todah for everything. Why? Because that is his commandment, to barak him, to give him todah in everything and for everything. Hallelujah, Yahweh. Hallelujah. We do barak y'all that are listening to this message tonight, somewhat of encouragement, a reminder that we zakah, remember that we do not forget the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, and that we continue to walk in them, Yisrael. We teach our children, we instruct our children, that they will go on and be great and mighty as they walk in the instructions and the commandments of Almighty Yahweh. Let us stand to our feet, Yisrael.
Hallelujah.
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 For Yahweh has also commanded us to shub, to turn. Hallelujah. So let us shub, let us turn, knowing that even though we are here in this captivity, Yisrael, yet by the commandments of Almighty Yahweh, he has made us free to serve him, to barak him, and to walk according to all of his Torah and his commandments. Almighty Yahweh, we do barak you for this time, this occasion, that we have gathered together here, and those that have gathered with us by via of live stream or radio tonight, Abba Yahweh, that we have heard and we have hearkened unto your commandments tonight, Yahweh, that we continue, that we walk in them, because we know that only walking in your commandments, your instructions, Almighty Yahweh, shall we find peace, shalom, that we find contentment, Abba Yahweh, and Ahava, obeying your commandments.
Yes.
So in all things we do give you todah, we barak you.
Yes.
In the precious and mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do ask, Abba Yahweh, you will go with those tonight that leave from this place or that are leaving from the places that are gathered, Abba Yahweh. And those that were not able to come to join, Abba Yahweh, that are listening, that you would give them great delight tonight in hearing the instructions of your commandments, Abba Yahweh. So all things we barak you, we give you todah. In the precious and mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do declare, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, Yahweh, hallelujah. Shalom, shalom, Kol Yisrael, shalom, shalom.